Welcome to the Gavel, your weekly Denver City Council wrap-up. Here's what happened this week. On Tuesday, May 23rd, the Land Use, Transportation, and Infrastructure Committee, along with Denver Parks and Rec, sent proposed designations for 9 parks throughout the Denver area to the full City Council. The parks total over 121 acres located in Council Districts 1, 3, 8, 9, and 11. Once designated, the parks cannot be sold or disposed of without the approval of voters. Parks must meet certain criteria to be considered, including having cultural significance, preservation of scenic vistas, and no ownership issues that could affect Denver's right to possession of the park.
This is what really makes it exciting to do this work, because we can build a park in a neighborhood that desperately needs it and really appreciates it. So really excited about this one.
This is the 14th round of park designation since 2013. Since then, over 1,900 acres of parks were designated, compared to 600 acres between 1956 and 2012.
These are the currently designated parks. As you can see by the color coding, the green ones are fully designated parks, blue are partially designated, and then the red are non-designated or open space. So that is something that is really, really important, because we are protecting parkland.
Also on May 23rd, the Finance and Governance Committee sent a request from the city's Technology Services Department for a cable TV franchise agreement to the full City Council for consideration. The contract allows for Denver to build, maintain, and operate a cable television system. Denver receives 5% of Comcast gross revenues within the city and county of Denver, and that money is not earmarked for a specific agency.
The franchise fee that comes in, the 5%, that goes to the general fund to help support all the services across the city. So, and then the PEG fund, the public education and government revenue that comes in, helps with capital expenses. So, you know, the infrastructure that we need to cover these meetings over our cable television channel.
The city and county of Denver produces programming focusing on public education and government media. Denver 8 produces and broadcasts all City Council legislative meetings and committees, press conferences, news events, and original arts and cultural programming. Denver Community Media is also part of this agreement. DCM provides multimedia training, tools, and a creative space for all members of all experience levels. They partner with Emily Griffith Technology College to provide accredited certificate programs and have a cable channel for content distribution out to Denver Public Schools. On Wednesday, May 24th, the Business Arts, Workforce, and Aviation Services Committee heard a briefing from the Denver International Airport on the Great Hall construction project. Planned in the construction is a new 17-lane security checkpoint, new check-in facilities, a meet-and-greet area for domestic and international arrivals, and a center for equity and excellence in aviation.
So much of this, as we move through this summer, is really going to look basically near completion. And come this fall, we're going to be starting to install those new security lanes and get them commissioned and get them up to speed as we go into the holidays and into the early year next year.
In the coming years, DEN is planning to build more security checkpoints and ticket counters for the southwest and southeast end of the terminals. The second phase of the Great Hall is projected to be finished in the first quarter of 2024.
Phase two, we are in a great place. We are very much from what I call budget healthy and schedule healthy, in that we are tracking ahead of schedule, and we constantly, there's not a meeting that I don't start off with our team saying, where are the opportunities to accelerate?
Also this week, City Council has passed the Near Southeast Area Plan. The draft plan offers a community vision for Southeast Denver that focuses on more housing options, safer streets, and responding to climate change, putting in place policies that will guide city decision-making for the next 20 years. The Safety, Housing, Education, and Homelessness Committee has sent to the full City Council a contract request for $625,000 to provide workforce training for immigrant and refugee community members on how to become a professional interpreter. City Council and all committees will not meet the week of May 29th due to the Memorial Day holiday. City Council and committees will resume the week of June 5th. Want more info on City Council, including weekly schedules and agendas? Visit denvergov.org/citycouncil. Denver City Council meets every Monday at 3:30 at the City and County Building Council Chambers, or tune in live on Denver 8 or Zoom. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube for Denver news, events, and information.